Hello guys, Shalini Ramnath here. Welcome to new video. Today we are going to see a journal from Anna University, Annexure 1. Okay. Title of the journal is An International Journal of Wireless Personal Communication. So this journal is Anna University, Annexure 1 journal. This is the homepage for the journal, and this is the journal link. Springer.com.journal/11277 is the journal link. And here you can find the editorial board. So chief editorial is Ramji Prasad from Denmark. And the associate editors are from Pakistan, Malaysia, Spain, and one more from Pakistan. An editorial board has so many countries, Singapore, Finland, even in India, there are some board members are from IIT Patna. And from NIIT University, India. Okay. After looking at the editorial members, we can look at the scope of the journal. Here they have given the aim and scope. In the home page itself, you can find aim and scope. So this journal accepts researchers from research from mobile communication and computing. Okay. So both theoretical and experimental aspects of articles they will accept. Here they have given published tutorial, survey and original research papers addressing mobile communication and computing. So once you submit a survey article for this journal, and after that if you want to submit a experimental results, there is a 90% of chance for accepting your articles. That is what mentioned over here. And in the home page itself, if you scroll down, you can see submission to first decision. So submission to first decision is 275 days. That means around 9 months. It takes around 9 months to get your first decision. Okay. And submission to acceptance is 352 days. The home page itself, if you scroll down little bit, you can find the latest issues. So this is a very recently published article. I'm opening this article to show you. See, this is the article title and these are the authors, the citation, DOI number, everything was given clearly, but you cannot access this entire PDF. In order to read this entire PDF, you have to pay certain amount provided over here. Meaning that this particular article is not open access. Next, I'm going back to home page. Under the tab of latest article, if you scroll down, you can see here this journal has 134 open access article. So these are open access article. I'm opening it over here. If you go, this 134 results are open access from this particular wireless personal communication. So if you click this title and try to open, it will get open. See, abstract, introduction, architecture, and you can see this entire manuscript over here itself. And if you want to download, in the right side top corner, you can find the download PDF. So likewise, you can download it also. The entire journal, the entire article can be downloaded and you can use it for your research purpose. This is purely open access, meaning that open access means your article is open for anyone, so that they can download it and read your article and they can cite your articles after reading your entire content. Mm. Again, I am coming back to the home page. If you scroll down, you can see journal updates, but I'll come later. Still, you scroll down. Here you can find abstract and indexed in. That is, you come down completely. A little bit more if you scroll down further upwards, then you can see the abstract and indexed in. Here they have mentioned it is Scopus and SCIE. Okay, these two. Apart from this, they have Google Scholar, InSpec, and DVLP, ACM Digital Library, and also a lot more indexing they have provided. See here, UGC CARE list or India is also there. So it is in UGC CARE, SCIE, and Scopus. Okay, this is the indexing of this journal. And coming back to journal updates, they have given call for papers. I'm going for this tab view all updates. So if you go to journal updates, they have given three special issue call for papers. So first one is blockchain for cognitive wireless communication network. This is the first special issue call for papers. Title is blockchain for cognitive wireless communication networks. So they have given a broad scope for this journal. Topic of this interest includes need for blockchain for privacy and safety in transmission of wireless network, a study of recent decentralized wireless network technology, blockchain for future cognitive wireless communication networks, cognitive based sensing and reasoning technology for blockchain enabled wireless networks. So likewise, they have mentioned a lot of scope for this journal, and submission for this journal is special issues July 29 to 2021. So this end of this month you have to submit your article. You will get a first review by October 3rd. And your publication date will be as per the journal decision, but the final notification will be on May 10, 2022. Next year May only you will be getting the final decision. Okay, these are the guest editors for the special issues. One from South Korea, the other one is USA. And next call for paper is natural and bio-inspired algorithm for secure wireless communication. For this one, this is the topic of interest, but submission deadline is over by last month itself. So I'm not going to say anything about this special issue. Coming back to the home updates page, here you can find third call for paper. Third call for paper is Intelligent Decision Support Systems for Wireless Communication in IoT Environment. This is the title of the special issue. Topic of interest is given over here. Smart City and Smart Home based on IDSS in IoT. Decision Making Enabled Mobile Smart Farming and Agriculture in Wireless Communication. IDSS on Vehicular Communication in IoT System. IDSS Model for Industrial IoT Application. Energy prediction and mobile sensor based IDS system in IoT. Intelligent decision making system for mobile computer aided diagnosis test system. So likewise, they have mentioned a lot of scope for this special issue. Blockchain technology and IDSs in IoT. Big data management based on mobile IDS in wireless communication. Mobile medical instrumentation and healthcare technologies in IoT. So a lot of interesting topics were mentioned over here. And next is deadline for submission. It is about 20th August 2021. And final decision, you will get it by 30th November. And tentatively, they will publish your article by first quarter of 2022. That means before April, your article will get published. And lead guest editor is from Turkey. And guest editors are from Italy and UK. Okay, they are from Department of Computer Science and Informations. Okay. And for all these call for paper, as well as for this wireless communication journal, the submission guideline is same. Okay. So this is the submission guidelines. Here they have mentioned the instruction for authors. First one is manuscript submission. Next, online submission. So you have to submit your manuscript online. You can find a tab over here, right? See this one, submit manuscript. Here, using this tab, you have to submit. If you click this tab, it will move on to the editorial manager website. This is the editorial manager of wireless personal communications site. In the site, as usual, you have to register yourself and create a login, and then you go to the author login and submit your article. In the submission, in the manuscript submission page, if you scroll down, you can see the title page. So your title page should contain all this information: author, name of the author, affiliation of the author, email ID, and 16-digit ORCID of the author. So you have to create your ORCID account, and then you have to provide the ORCID ID. But this is an optional case, if available. Okay. And then abstract. Abstract is 150 to 250 words. You should write your abstract of around 150 to 250 words. And keyword should be 4 to 5 keywords. And all the manuscripts should contain the following section under the declaration. So once you finish writing your article, after the conclusion section or before the reference section, you have to include this declaration. Okay. In this declaration, you have to include funding, conflict of interest, availability of data and material, code availability, author's contribution. If any of this doesn't match for you, then you have to mention it is not applicable for me. So you have, if you don't have any funding, you write this funding and then you mention, you put a hyphen and you mention it as not applicable. But you have to include all these components inside your manuscript after the conclusion section. And next is, you have to, you can submit your manuscript in the Word or PDF. That is in case of initial submission. Your first submission can be a Word or PDF. Anything they will accept. But once you get revision, you have to prepare your manuscript in the LaTeX format, and entire source file have to be submitted to this journal. This is the LaTeX package to prepare your article after you get the revision. Okay. And reference or citation. So inside your text, you have to refer your citation with a square bracket. If you have multiple reference, then you have to write it as 1, 2, 3 within a hyphen. So within a square bracket, you have to include the hyphen to mention one or two more than one citations. Okay, and strictly you have to follow APA version for writing this reference. So this APA versions can be obtained from artificial intelligence something. Okay. So in this, you see here, there is a double quote symbol, right? If you click this, you can find here APA. This is the format we have to follow for this particular journal. This is APA format. What is the special about this APA format is the name of the journal will be in the italics. Okay, so you can copy this over from here and you can make use of this reference. Okay. Next is reference list. So if it is a journal article, the journal's name should be in the italic. If it is an article by DOI, again the name of the articles should be italic. If it is a book, name of the book should be italic. if it is a book chapter, name of the book chapter should be italic. If it is an online document, then you have to mention who has written this particular website, particular content of the website, and when they have written and published it, and what is the title. The title should be in italic format, and when you have retrieved that particular information, and what is the link, total full link, full length link should be provided. So this is the way you have to prepare your reference list for this wireless personal communication journal. Next is table. They have given few points to prepare your journal table, and as well as the figures, there are some guidelines to preparing your figure. It should be in a EPS format. And rest, you have lots and lots of information for preparing your manuscript. And in the same page, if you scroll down, you can see English language editing. So here they have given few tools and softwares for that. First one is free online grammar check. So you can utilize this link to check your grammar for your prepared manuscript. Okay, get your free grammar check. You can get started over here and you can upload your entire document and you can get verified for the grammars. And next one is English language tutorial. This also you can make use of it. Here you can learn basic English. Next is Nature Research Editing Service. This is the service provided by this journal. I'll tie up with this Springer Nather Author Service. So here you have to upload your manuscript. You can get services like correcting the English and then formatting the journal. As well, one more link is they have provided American Journal Expert. So here also you can get a service like making your journal formatting and English correction, all these things. But everything is paid. You have to pay for this. And don't think that if you go for these kind of services, your article will get acceptance. It is not the case. They will just only correct your English and make your article to the journal's format. Okay. This is given as a note for you. Does not imply or guarantee that the article will be selected for peer review or acceptance. Okay. So if you go for this editing service, it is not guaranteed that your paper will get selected for peer review or acceptance. Okay. But you can make use of this. You can learn the English to this tutorial as well. You can use this free online grammar checks. Okay. And if you feel lazy to edit your manuscript, you can also use these two services to format your document. So that's all in this submission guidelines page. Let me move on to here back in the same submission guidance page itself. They have given open access publishing. So you just explore this and understand what they have mentioned for open access publishing. Okay. So publishing open access in this journal, this wireless personal communication is a transformative journal. When research is accepted for publication, authors can choose to publish using either the traditional publishing routine or via golden access. So you can submit your manuscript to this journal. Once you got acceptance, then they will ask you whether you want to publish your article as a traditional route or as a golden open access. It is your choice. Okay. And here they have mentioned article processing charge. If you go for traditional publishing model, then there is no article processing charge. And if you go for open access, then you have to pay a huge amount to get your article open access. Next, I am going to home page. Hope I have shown you all the information, right? Ethics. If you are this journalist, Scopus as well as SEIE, right? In order to confirm that, you go to scopus.com and then here you go for source and then type the journal name. You will get this information: wireless personal communication Scopus coverage year is from 1994 to till now present. Okay, publisher is Springer Nature. And if you click this home page, you can find the journal's home page. See, 112 77. So this is in the Scopus. In order to check the wireless personal communication journal whether it is SEIE or not, you have to go for mglclarivate.com. Here you have to log in, then only you have to search for the details about the journal. So I already logged in. Here it shows the logout symbol. So here in the search tab, I have typed the wireless personal communication and then I searched it. The results shows the journal's name and then publisher and then Web of Science core collection is SEIE. Okay. Again, you go to this view profile page and then verify the journal's web page as well as the publisher's website. If you click it should open the corresponding journal website as well as the publisher website. Yeah, it's opening over here. Okay, so it is a good journal or it's not a fake or a clone journal. Okay, and here they have mentioned Web of Science and coverage area. It is SCIE. Okay, so guns under telecommunication, mobile computing or mobile communication. And this is for computer science researchers who do their research in mobile communication or mobile computing. Okay. That's all about to share about this wireless personal communication journal, which is an Anna University Annexure 1 journal. Thank you.